thank him enough for what he's done for me. I can't thank him enough for what he's done for me. I can't thank him enough
for what he's done for me.
I can't thank him
enough for what he's done for me.
He came down, yes he did, yes he did. Oh, what the man has done. Oh, oh, what the Lord has
done.
Oh, what?
Oh, what he's done for you and me. Oh, what he's done for you and me.
He sent his only son to die on Calvary. What the Lord has done.
Oh, what he's done for you and me.
Oh, oh, what the Lord has done.
Oh, what he's done for you and me.
I can't thank him enough.
I can't thank him enough. For what he's done for me.
I can't thank him enough.
I can't thank him enough. For what he's done for me.
I can't thank him enough.
I can't thank him enough. For what he's done for me.
I can't thank him enough.
I can't thank him enough. For what he's done for me.
He came down.
He came down.
Yes, he did. Yes, he did. Oh, what the man has done. Oh, oh, what the Lord has done.
Oh, what he's done for you and me.
Oh, oh, the Lord has done.
Oh, what he's done for you and me.
Oh, oh, what the Lord has done.
Oh, what he's done for you and me.
Oh, what he has done for you and me. We come together to give thanks to God for that in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. May the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We gather on this Thanksgiving Day to be reminded of the abundant gifts that God has given to us, and this invitation for us to render our hearts in gratitude for God's goodness, God's grace, and God's continued giftedness in the person of Jesus Christ. We gather with his word, we gather with the body and blood of his son Jesus to recognize that true gift in our own life and that true meal that sustains. But oftentimes in the midst of our own journeys, we forget and take for granted the many gifts that God has given to us. For those times, we ask the Lord's pardon and forgiveness.
Lord,
and may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. Of the will,
magnify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God Almighty Father.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Glory to God.
And on earth,
peace to people of goodwill.
Take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen, amen.
Glory to God.
And let us pray. Lord, this is the day that our country has marked out as a way of giving thanks to you. But Lord, we know every day, every moment of every day is an opportunity for us to give you thanks. For more than anything else, the gift of your Son Jesus in our own life. For the gift of life in our own midst. For the gift of love with whom we encounter and the people that you put in front of us, who are indeed the presence of your Son Jesus. May this Thanksgiving Day remind us. May it challenge us. May it remind us of that original Thanksgiving Day to which folks gathered and gave thanks to you for the abundance of harvest and gift that they have received. As well, may it also challenge us to extend beyond ourselves and to truly be Christ's presence to those in need. May we allow the abundance of this day to remind us of the needs in our own world and for us to respond in a way that is full of your goodness and grace. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever, and let the church say, Amen.
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 A reading from the book of Sirach. And now, bless the God of all, who has done wondrous things on earth, who fosters people's growth from their mother's womb and fashions them according to his will. May he grant you joy of heart, and may peace abide among you. May his goodness toward us endure in Israel to deliver us in our day. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. In the sight of the angels, I will sing your praises, Lord. In the sight of the angels, I
sing your praises, Lord.
I will give thanks to you, Lord, with all my heart, for you have heard the words of my mouth. In the presence of the angels, I will sing your praise. I will worship at your holy temple and give thanks to your name. In the sight of the angels, I will sing your praises, Lord. Because of your kindness and your truth, for you have made great above all things your name and your promise. When I called, you answered me. You built up strength within me. In the sight of the angels, I will sing your praises, Lord. All the kings of the earth shall give thanks to you, O Lord, when they hear the words of your mouth. And they shall sing of the ways of the Lord. Great is the glory of the Lord.
In the sight of the angels, I will sing your praises, Lord.
Your right hand saves me. The Lord will complete what he has done for me. Your kindness, O Lord, endures forever. Forsake not the work of your hands.
In the sight of the angels, I will sing your praises, Lord. In the sight of the angels, I will sing your praises, Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God, always on your account, for the grace of God bestowed on you in Christ Jesus, that in him you were enriched in every way, with all discourse and all knowledge. As the testimony to Christ was confirmed among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift, as you wait for the revelation of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will keep you firm to the end, irreproachable on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful, and by him you were called to fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Circumstances, give thanks,
For this is the will of God for you in Christ Jesus. Alleluia. 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 Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus continued his journey to Jerusalem, he traveled through Samaria and Galilee. As he was entering a village, 10 lepers approached him. They stood at a distance from him and raised their voices, saying, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." And when he saw them, he said, "Go show yourselves to the priests." As they were going, they were cleansed. And one of them, realizing that he had been healed, returned, glorifying God in a loud voice, and he fell at the feet of Jesus and thanked him. He was a Samaritan. Jesus said in reply, 10 were cleansed, were they not? Where are the other 9? Has none but this foreigner returned to give thanks to God?" Then he said to him, "Stand up and go. Your faith has saved you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I think if there's any kind of secular holiday that seems to have as its core a set of rituals, it would have to be Thanksgiving. And I think a lot of us who have celebrated Thanksgiving since we were kids, back in our day, it was always the beginning of the Christmas season. So when you say holiday season, it generally began Thanksgiving, not at 4th of July like you would have these days. So, but there's always a sense of what that day ritually looks like for us. I mean, for a lot of us, it would be going to Mass or starting out with prayer, or watching the Macy's Thanksgiving parade, you know, while the smells of all kinds of stuff are emanating from the kitchen, turkey, stuffing, mashed potatoes, yams. As Asian people, it'd be like all kind of dead animals. So it was just kind of things like that. So, and of course, and it come time to eat. You know, again, words of thanksgiving, words of prayer, perhaps. Obviously, and always a prayer for those who are hungry and not as fortunate to experience the abundance of that day. Maybe 2 or 3 hours later, everyone's comatose on some couch somewhere, and you're going to go watch the Detroit Lions play at Chicago Bears, or the Green Bay Packers, or Dallas, or something. And then the rest of the evening spent with regaling with family and friends. That's the essence of kind of what Thanksgiving for a lot of us is about. But you don't hear a single one of those references in any of the readings from Sirach and Corinthians and Luke. It's always a sense of gratitude. You hear that in the psalm as well, too. To give thanks to God for that which we have received. And that's the essence of what this day is about. And it's not that we do that like once a year. We do that constantly. I mean, I have an app on my phone that reminds me, I think once or twice every few hours, what am I giving thanks to God for? What am I giving thanks to God for? So today we formally as a country do that, but we're invited in so many different ways on a fairly regular basis to recognize those gifts. Particularly in light of the pandemic, a lot of us are able to look back and say, geez, you know, we made it through. We were able to get through only by and purely by the grace of God and the generosity of Christ Jesus in our own life and his love for us. So I invited folks as part of our own gathering as we tape this, record this Thanksgiving Day Mass, to maybe express a little bit about their own reasons to give thanks to God. So I'm going to invite members of our choir who are gathered here today to help celebrate, I was going to say Christmas. Jump the gun like everyone else does. To celebrate Thanksgiving, to go ahead and maybe share something you'd like to give thanks for. So we're going to focus the attention on you and approach the mic there and maybe give some thought to that.
Oh, you go first.
Well, you stole some of my thunder. I guess one of the biggest things that I'm thankful for is that I'm still here.
Amen.
you know, no COVID, got my shots and all that. And I'm really thankful for family. You know, traditionally, Joe and I host the family Thanksgiving dinner. Now, this is going to be the second year that we can't do that. You know, one, I'm getting too old to hustle all that stuff around the house. And two, it's just following CDC guidelines, there's not enough ventilation in our house to gather 15, 20 people. So I'm thankful for modern technology that's going to let us Zoom Thanksgiving. So that's, and looking at what's happening politically in other states, I'm thankful I live in California.
Amen.
That's about it.
It's not going to say anything, but I'm very thankful for my family. I'm very thankful for my church family. I am particularly very thankful for the fact that about 20 years ago, after visiting churches in Oakland for over 20 years, Clarence and I came to St. Benedict's. And it was the feelings that we received from St. Benedict's that it said, you should stay. And about 20 years later, we're still here. Amen. And it's still, I'm very grateful, very thankful for that, as well as from Director Leonard Pete. Because in 2011, he said, I said, can Erin be in the choir? She had graduated from high school. He said, sure. I said, I'll just sit out and I'll just bring her. He said, no, you're going to be in the choir and sing too. But then he encouraged Erin to sing. She had a solo the very first year. And he just said, no, Erin can do it. Erin can do it. And for that blessing, I am very, very grateful and very thankful that we are at St. Benedict's. We're participating in the choir, and I just love and love my church family, along with, of course, my family. But I'm very grateful, very thankful that we were given that opportunity. Just happy. Thank you.
Amen. Yeah, everyone is stealing each other's thunder. So, I mean, just to piggyback on what Mars and Wandra have said so far, it's the same for me. Very, very thankful and grateful for the love and support of family. Not only my immediate family, but my church family, my extended family, because everyone knows that it was some rough times during this past almost 2 years now, but we're still here. We made it. So I'm so blessed and so grateful that that I'm safe and well. I mean, we've all experienced some sort of death in the family due to COVID, but you know what? We know that they're in a better place right now, but just so grateful. I'm so grateful for family and the support and the love that I continue to receive each and every day, each year that I've been here. I've been here 16 years now, going on 17 years. I mean, you know, time flies. So thankful for just family. Thankful, very thankful.
I think everyone has already expressed what I would say about being thankful for family, and especially the church here at St. Benedict's. When we moved to Oakland, believe it or not, we searched for years to find a church that we would, that we could feel part of. And we went to a memorial service for one of our friends, and Father Jay was the celebrant. And after that service, we asked him, well, what church are you the pastor of? And he told us about St. Benedict's. And again, I had, you know, when I was a kid, I was an altar boy and all that, and went to Jesuit school, brainwashed, but could not But could not find a church here in Oakland until we found St. Benedict's and now the choir. Wandra got me to join the choir, and I love playing the guitar here and the music and the opportunity that Leonard has given me. So, and not to mention my health over the last, I'm in my 70s and I'm still alive despite COVID. So, what can I say? Thank you.
Amen.
I want to give thanks to my God for, he has done so much for me, but the main thing that I praise him for was him leading me here. I had been looking for a church for years, and I came to St. Benedict in 82 and never left. It just seemed like everybody embraces you, and that's a feeling that you don't want to leave you. And I have not been disappointed in all the years that I've been here. And I'm thankful for friends and family. My family is 3,000 miles away, but this is my family. I can run to them quicker than I can run back. So I am very blessed to have St. Benedict and my pastor as my saviors.
Amen.
Thank you.
Well, I'll wait for Judy first.
Okay. Back to the light. Well, I wake up every morning and it's like, thank you, God, for letting me have another day to live in your footsteps and try to stay faithful to you. But I'm also so grateful for the love and support of my family and my church family and my friends. And we just got back from a family vacation. We went down to Louisiana, Mississippi to kind of rediscover the roots of the family, and we had such a wonderful time. And so that will be a memory that I hold for a very long time. And I'm grateful that my sons are coming this week to celebrate with me, and it'll be so wonderful to have them home. Thank you.
Well, yeah, just a little PS. I think one of the other things that everybody in our parish is thankful for is the presence of you, Father Jason.
Amen. Amen.
You have, how should I put this, kept the ball rolling. You came in here and you continue to let us be St. Benedict's. So thank you as well.
Amen.
ST, smooth transition. Beautiful.
It appears as if I'm following Morris. However, it wasn't a forget. I just wanted to say that I'm very thankful for a wonderful woman I met and really got to know here at St. Benedict's, who then became the surrogate, as she would say, the main mother of my daughter, and who has to be Godmama Betty Kennedy Tapscott. And she has been so wonderful in Aaron's life, like a mother, for the past, I don't know, 15 or 20 years, and she is her real godmother. I like to tell people she was baptized. And Betty Kennedy Tapscott is that, but for all the wonderful things that Betty does for everyone, and what she's done for my daughter, and what she continues to do for everyone. Amen. Thank you.
Amen.
Definitely, to reiterate the sentiments of everyone, we're thankful to be here. We are grateful to have what we have. We live in gratitude, we live in appreciation. We are blessed to have this roof as well as a regular roof over our head to pray, to thank, to worship, to engage, to cherish each other, to create memories. So I'm thankful for moments like that. I'm thankful for having a church home that I could still call a church home, right? After growing up here and moving away and going to college and still being able to come back and find a way to still give. So I'm grateful to be here, grateful for all that everyone here does for each one of us. Thank you and God bless.
Amen.
Amen.
So may this day be for you and for a lot of us an opportunity to certainly give thanks to God, but as well to recognize all the many gifts, the very practical gifts, and I don't mean gifts, I mean gifts as people and relationships that have helped us to recognize Christ's particular presence in our own midst. And I'm always particularly grateful for the people that I have the opportunity to journey with in ministry here at St. Benedict, who continue to remind me of God's goodness, God's abundant grace, and how many people God has gifted with the treasure of time, talent, and treasure that have enabled this community to continue to build upon the work that was done for many years, particularly by my predecessor, Jay Matthews. So to all of you, a very happy and blessed Thanksgiving. May it be an opportunity always to give thanks to God for goodness in our own life. And as we gather around this table of Eucharist to share the gift of bread and wine, may you, as you gather around your table, filled with all the goodies we've talked about earlier, take this as an opportunity to give thanks always to God. Amen.
Amen.
As a people of faith, we give you thanks on this Thanksgiving Day with hearts full with gratitude. It's in that sense of gratitude that we present to the many needs and prayers still of the community of faith here at St. Benedict. We pray for our world so full of its own need for healing that our ability to give thanks to you would extend the healing presence of your Son in our hurting world. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
On this day of abundance, we are keenly and acutely aware of those who are in need today on all kinds of different levels, particularly on a material level. For those who are hungry this day in the midst of the plenty that we experience, somehow our hearts, our society, our culture, our government may be transformed always to extend that loving care to those most vulnerable and needy in our midst. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those struggling in any way of health, mind, body, and spirit, that God's continued healing presence would be theirs. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Oh, for peace and justice in our world, for peace and justice on our streets, for the healing of our streets here in Oakland, for the that we may respond not with violence, but with a peaceful presence amidst the cacophony of what we experience here. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray for the intercession of those who continue to be on track for the process of beatification and canonization within our own church, particularly those within our own Catholic, African-American Catholic community, from Henriette DeLille to Pierre Toussaint to Julia Greenlee to Father Augustus Tolton to Sister, oh, Sister Thea Bowman. This is my mom. And everybody else, we ask their blessing. We ask their intercession. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And I'll quit while I'm ahead. Loving and gracious God, with hearts full of thanksgiving, we are full of gratitude for your love. May we gather around this table of plenty, the gift of bread and wine that is your Son, and enable us to be aware of how we are called to be the healing presence of him in our world. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
I am grateful for its gratefulness. I am grateful for the things that you have done. Yes, I'm grateful for the victories we've won. I could go on and on and on about your works, because I'm grateful, grateful, so grateful just to praise you, Lord. Flowing from my heart are the issues of my heart, its gratefulness. Grateful, grateful, grateful. It's flowing from my heart. Grateful, 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 gratefulness. It's flowing from my heart.
Pray, my sisters, and pray, my brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of our hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and good of all God's holy church.
Amen. Amen. Almighty God, from whose hand we have received generous gifts, so that we might learn to share your blessings in gratitude, accept these gifts of bread and wine, and let the perfect sacrifice of Jesus draw us closer to all our sisters and brothers in the human family, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. It's our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. You have entrusted to us a great gift of freedom, a gift that calls forth responsibility and commitment, commitment to the truth that all have a fundamental dignity before you. In Jesus, through his death and resurrection, we find our ultimate redemption, freedom from sin, and every blessing. And so, with hearts full of love, we join the angels today and every day of our lives to sing your glory as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come, until you come, until you come again. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come, until you come, until you come again. Until you come, until you come, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partake of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, and all of your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and for my divine teaching, we dare to sing. Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be freed from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, forever and ever. Amen. For the kingdom,
Lord Jesus Christ, you say to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of God be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let's give each other the sign of Christ's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
And this is our Thanksgiving meal. This is the meal that never ends, the feast that never ends. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Just before I close my eyes to sleep, I thank the Lord for being good, kind, and sweet. I may not have done all that I wanted to do, but Lord, it's been a in the evening, when the sun has gone down, I thank the Lord for the days past and gone. I may not have done everything I've wanted to do, but Lord, it's been a it's been a good day,
a mighty good day.
Oh, it's been a good day,
good day, a mighty good day.
It's been a good day.
Lord, it's been a mighty good day.
that theme of how good God's been to me. I kneel down and thank Him. Oh, can't you see? I may not have done all that I wanted to do, but Lord, it's been a mighty good day, a mighty good day. It's been a good day. Everything I've wanted to do, but Lord, it's been a mighty good, but Lord, it's been a mighty good, but Lord, it's been a mighty good day, a mighty good day.
Amen. Amen.
And let us pray. Lord, each and every day has been a mighty good day. We recognize the many gifts that we've received, and though we know at times that days can be overwhelming for us, we more often than not are able to at least glimpse upon the goodness of your grace throughout the day, where you have been able to be present to us. And on this day that we set aside to give you thanks as a nation, we give you praise and thanks for getting us through what we have to get through these days. And we ask that today be set aside as a moment of profound gratitude and an always a challenge for us to live the presence of your Son, Jesus. We who have been nourished by his body and blood and fed by his word may continue to allow ourselves to be instruments of your healing care. We ask us through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
On behalf of the parish and staff here at St. Benedict Church, we wish for each and every one of you a very blessed and holy Thanksgiving Day, a day full of family and friends, a day that connects you to the abundant grace of God, and a day that challenges us always to share that grace and abundance with those around us. Amen?
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Hold on. Choir, thank you. I can do that. Judy, thank you. Well, thank you. Leonard, here I am doing the whole Thanksgiving thing. I didn't even give thanks. What's that all about? Come on, man. I know I do, but it's Thanksgiving Day. All the more reason to give you thanks. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Let's try this again. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God. I'll never stop praising God. I'll never stop praising Him. He woke me up this morning and started me on my way. I'll never stop praising Him. I'll never stop praising God. I'll never stop praising Him. He woke me up this morning and started me on my way. I'll never stop praising Him.
Last time.
I'll never stop praising God. I'll never stop praising Him.
He woke
me up this morning and saw me on my way.
He woke me up this morning
and saw me on my way. He woke me up this morning.